I think I'm right in saying that in the context of robotics history, this was one of the top Series Bs of all time. It's a significant sum of money. Let's start with what you're going to do with that funding and what you need to do to make progress.
Right, Ed. First of all, thank you for having me. It's a pleasure to be here. What we're developing at ForSight, as you said, it's a robotic platform to tackle one of the biggest needs in medicine, which is the vision crisis. So currently today, we have over 2 billion people who are vision impaired, and that creates a yearly $3 trillion economic burden. And this crisis is mostly due to the lack of surgeons to cater to this massive amount of patients and the lack of quality of standard in eye care. So what we're doing at ForSight, as you mentioned, we're taking AI and other technologies to augment surgeons' capabilities and have them doing many more procedures in a very precise right. and accurate way. And we're starting with cataract, which is our first indication.
Dr. Nathan, how big is the addressable market here?
So this is one of the biggest markets in medicine. This is the most common procedure in all of medicine. Cataracts is not a disease, it's a widespread condition that happens during age. So it will happen to everybody eventually. And we don't keep up with the amount of surgeries that needs to be done. So today, for example, we can do globally 30 million procedures a year, but there's over 600 million patients who need it. So there's really no human way to close this gap. And as you mentioned, this is the second largest B round in surgical robotics history. And this round is going to take us where we are today. So we did 300 procedure in animal models, and we're going to do our first in human clinical trials later this year, and it's going to take us through regulatory approvals and early commercialization.
Dr. Nathan, you join us from Israel, and we have to address the events of the last few weeks. Would you just reflect on what it's been like closing this round, but also just trying to build out the technology in an environment where Israel is at war with Iran?
Yeah, you're definitely right. There were usually, you know, there's volatility in the Middle East, but this was different. We had ballistic missiles dropping from the sky. We had, you know, to run with our kids to the shelters. But there's in our spirit and the Israeli spirit is that Israeli tech delivers no matter what. And during missiles coming from the sky, we closed this B round. And, you know, this company was started 5 years ago during COVID. We went through a very big economic recession, the war in Gaza, and now Iran. So this vote of confidence by investors and also a strategic partner that we joined to this round is truly amazing. And I think is a testament to the Israeli resilient and our ability to get through hurdles. If it's, you know, uncertainty in the Middle East, it could be uncertainty during development. We're developing a disruptive solution that's very hard to do. So I'm very, very proud of the team for, you know, enduring this.
I ask you about the operational experience of recent weeks, because we also talked about the addressable market, and it's likely, right, that addressable market is outside of Israel. So
right.
is it the future of this company that you maintain your talent pool, your operations in that country, or you need to look at expanding globally to capture that market?
Right. We are a global company. Our first target market is the U.S. We're going to transition our operation to the U.S. We are very privileged, Ed, as you said, to be doing good. And our addressable market, you know, people have cataract regardless of their ethnicity, geography, etc. So our first target market is the U.S. We're going to transition our operation there, but also to other places. So you're definitely right. It's outside of the realms of Israel.
What I find so interesting about the technology is it blends robotics, hardware, with software. What would you say is your core competence?
Well, it's phased. So you start with a lot of, you know, building very small mechanics, and then, you know, software is like the brain takes over. So think of what we're doing like, you know, superhuman extension of, you know, the surgeon's hands and arms, coupled with best-in-class visualization and this software brain that operates everything and gives the surgeons the ability to be more precise and accurate in every case. And when I try to explain what we're doing, what we want to achieve, we want to transform the average surgeon to the Michael Jordan of surgeons, but in every procedure, you know, regardless if it's the first procedure of the day or the last procedure of the day. And that's really what it's all about.
I'll ask you again what you plan to do with the funding. There's a real premium on software talent in particular right now, but across robotics.
Right. So, you know, we're fortunate enough to get, and we have, I saw you, NVIDIA is, you know, our neighbors and Facebook and Apple. So we're competing with those companies on the best talent. What we have is, you know, the ability to give our team member join a journey to transform the ophthalmic market. So currently, there's, you know, no robotics on the ophthalmic market, while other specialties have gained robotics for 10 to 15 years. And this is because, you know, we didn't have the miniaturization, the technological advancement that happened over the last, you know, maybe 5 years in order to get a robotic platform doing such a precise micro-level movements. And when you're talking about computing power or software, you know, the NVIDIAs of the world gave us the ability to have right. this computer power to control this micro-level precision. So it's, you know, interconnected here.